Divi button hover effects? You don't need those. Okay, I lied. Coming up. Hey, Thomas Garrett's here. Thanks for tuning in. So if you're new here, what we do on this channel, it's everything affiliate marketing, and I like to do tutorials about how to grow your business online with some of the tools I use. So if that kind of content you're interested in, go down below, hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that notification bell too so you get notified every time I upload. I guess I'm going through puberty. My little voice squeaked there. So anyways, what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna show you how to do these button hover effects, and I'm not talking about adding a little icon. I'm talking about hovers like this, you know, like this. Super, super cool. And there's a way to actually do this in the Divi builder without having to know coding and none of that stuff. I was looking online to try and figure out how to do these button hover effects, and for hours I wasted trying to find this, and none of the codes worked. Everything was outdated, expired from these WordPress gurus talking about their hover effects being super simple, and it's like I put them all in, none of them worked, right? So it's super annoying. And then I finally find out that there's a way to do it inside of the Divi builder, and it's super simple. And I know I don't really do WordPress videos on my channel, but I felt like this was such an important topic that will save you so much time. And I'm more than happy to do more WordPress tutorials, but just let me know in the comments down below if you want me to. I'd really appreciate it. So now let's get into it. I'm going to show you how to add the hover effects to your Divi buttons in literally seconds. Let's do it. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna enable Visual Builder, okay? All right, so you just go to any button, okay? So you're just gonna, you can double click it, or you can, if you wanna do it the other way, you just go here and then you click the little gear icon, okay? So what you're gonna wanna do now is you're gonna wanna go to design, and you're gonna wanna click on button, okay? Because that's what we're editing, the button. Now, you see how this thing pops up when I mouse over it? So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna hit this little mouse icon, okay? So click that, and now you see there's an option, default and hover. It's insane, it's so simple. I had no idea. Okay, but just so you know, normally you have to click on them. Like I already have this one clicked on from when I was doing it, so just know that if you change this one, it's not gonna change it for that as well, okay? So remember that, very, very important. So right now what you can do is you can go to the button text color, you can change it to hover, right? And you can click on this one, click that, and then you'll be clicking on all of them. Then you can do it all at once rather than doing one at a time. It just makes more sense to me. So that's what it looks like when it's hovered on. This is default, okay? So it's super simple. So if you wanna change the text size, you can change the text size. Okay, so now it can get bigger when you hover over it, right? So super, super powerful stuff. I don't use that. The reason why I don't use that is because this is something a lot of people don't look at when they're doing online business and stuff, right? So when you're actually on the website, let's open up an incognito. Okay, so we'll go to thomasgarretts.com, and this is a hack that no one talks about. I don't know why, but look, everyone edits in their own screen, right? They don't take the time to check small mobile, medium mobile, large laptop, small laptop, tablet, 4K, you know what I mean? People don't think like that, but you have to check it because not everyone's gonna be using a 4K like I am. Not everyone's gonna be using a laptop like you are or whatever, you know what I mean? So it's very important. And when you're on WordPress, when you go to like desktop or phone, they're not like the ideal sizes. This is just, you can change the sizes, but it's never gonna be for all of them. You know what I mean? So a lot of people just edit it for this, right? And that's fine. It's better than nothing, but just know this. So let's go back to this page. So when you right click and hit inspect, you're gonna wanna go to mobile small. You're gonna wanna go to mobile medium, mobile large. You're gonna wanna look at how everything looks, right? You're gonna wanna go to tablet, laptop, laptop large, 4K, you know what I mean? So that's what you wanna do. You wanna check all of those. And one thing that I do on mine, you can see I have three versions of this. So what I did is I just have one that's invisible on desktop and mobile and only visible on tablet, et cetera, right? That way it looks good on all of them, because it's hard to make one look good on all three devices, plus the small, large, medium, you know what I mean? So anyways, that's just a little extra hack. Now let's get back to actually doing this hover thing. I'm sure you probably get it by now. It's super simple. I can't believe I spent hours looking up online for CSS that's expired, outdated, doesn't work, and there was this option in the Divi theme the entire time. It's amazing. And you can just add these Divi hover effects to your buttons. Super simple. I was literally in awe. Like, honestly, I was like, wow, are you serious? You know what I mean? So anyway, so we're gonna go back to the hover version. And what you can do a lot of things. The one thing you can't change is like the text. So for the icon, you can have it. You have to go down here, only show icon on hover. So you can do that. But for the text, you can't like change the font. You know what I mean? You can change the text size, but not like the font, right? So just so you know that. So what I do is I just have all of my buttons the same, except for I have, did I just screw that up? See, that's another reason why I don't use this thing. So look at the button icon right here. Look, it just shows up right at the bottom there because it's not big enough. So I don't use those, and I don't make the text bigger when you hover because that could mess up stuff. You know what I mean? So I just keep it simple. And I think that's the best policy is just being simple. But yeah, so the only other button I have on my page that's any different than all these is the subscribe button. So hover and it changes to green and black. I think it's just good to have like a general color for your brand and just keep it, you know, somewhat like I have dark green here, I have blue and green, and then I have black. And then the only one that's red is the subscribe button for YouTube, which makes sense, right? So again, if you're confused, you just double click on this, go to design button, and then you're gonna wanna go to this little mouse click thing, and then you go to hover. And that's how you change it, okay? It's super, super simple. You can change it to gradient, right? So you can do some cool stuff with this. So you could go down here and you could go to like black and let's go to like green, right? So you could do some cool stuff and then change this to white. You know what I mean? So that's the hover. And then that's regular, and then you hover, and it's, you can do some really cool things with Divi. And I'm not gonna get too in depth with this video just because it's like super insane the kind of stuff you could do, but let me know in the comments below if you like these WordPress tutorials. Also, if you have any questions at all, I know I kind of went through this quick, just put it in the comments down below. And if you want to watch some more videos from me, I'm gonna link one up here and I'm gonna link another one up here for you. And if you really like this video, do me a favor, click my face right here and support the channel. I really appreciate it. Again, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I answer all of them. And that's all I got. Till next time.